time for a new segment we're calling Credit Check. Here's how it works. We're going to talk about some players in the league that are playing very well that aren't really getting the credit, hence the title, that they deserve. Whit, you're up first. Who do you want to talk about? Whose tires do you want to pump?
My man, Timo Meier. Switzerland product, 9th overall pick in 2015, and a big physically dominant winger who people wondered what they'd get out of him this year. He's been playing with Logan Couture and Thomas Hertl, and he has 12 goals already in just 19 games played. So San Jose looks to Couture and Pavelski and Joe Thornton, but if this guy can continue the pace he's on, become 30, maybe a 40-goal scorer, which he really looks like he's able to be, you see that move in Philly, that just adds to their strength and their depth at forward. So if you look at, you know, with the team, he's leading the team in goals. He's great in front of the net on the power play. And, you know, he's not overly tall, around 6'6", but a heavy guy, hard to move, with a lot more skill than people realize. So when you're talking about getting credit, he really deserves more than you've really heard so far. And I understand they got Brent Burns, they got Erik Karlsson, who hasn't had the greatest start. So Timo Meier is a name that's new to some people, but I think you'll be noticing it and hearing it a lot more in the near future.
They got big personalities in San Jose.
They do.
But watching last year, the second half of last year, I really started noticing him, and you're right, he deserves more credit. He's going to be a heck of a player.
Yeah, well, when we talk about San Jose, we talk about Burns and Thornton and those bigger name, bigger bearded guys.
Yes.
When we think Colorado Avalanche, we think Nathan McKinnon, Mikko Rantanen, but there's someone on that team that catches your eye as
well. I want to give a little love to Tyson Barrie because, you know, he's someone, people look at Tyson Barrie, he's a puck-moving defender. He's an offensive defenseman, and people always want to be critical of his play in the D zone. And listen, you know, there's no perfect players in this league. You can't, you know, some guys are really good offensive defensemen, some guys are good defensive defensemen. But look at the numbers this year for him. He's a plus 12. He's got 13 assists, 14 points, playing more than 20 minutes a night. Right shot, puck moving defender, really complements that top line when he's out there with those guys, helps them get the puck with speed through the neutral zone. If those guys aren't moving out of their zone with speed and being able to attack off the rush, maybe they're not as good as they have been so far this year. So Tyson Barrie is a very important piece of the puzzle for the Colorado Avalanche. Yes, this is a team that is getting better. Their defense is getting stronger. They've got some guys in the pipeline. But don't estimate this guy's abilities. And you can see there, plus minus right near the top of the league with that plus 12.
How's Nashville doing 5-on-5? Like 4-on-5 guys. That's incredible. But I love Barrie. I love Barry's game. Plays with pace. That's what you need to see now, which is great. I have another guy, though.
You got one?
Oh,
can I bring up another guy?
Yes,
I
have three guys. You must be excited. Actually, I was going to tee you up, but you're excited.
Three.
Ironically enough, this guy that I'm going to now talk about, we hear a lot in Vancouver about Elias Pettersson, understandably
the dominant
start to his career he's had. But the true leader of that team, and I think the future captain of that team, is Bo Horvat.
Yeah,
and this is a guy who plays with passion and is very hard to play against. So there's a lot of skill there. And ironically enough, I brought up Timo Meier. Bo Horvat was also the 9th overall pick, just happened to be in 2013. He has 17 points in 20 games, 9 goals, 8 assists. It's even there. He's a guy who I think will always be even. If he gets 30 goals, it'll be around 35, 40 assists. But he's somebody that, when I say leader, it's both ends of the ice. So he's not only playing offensively, he's not only scoring goals by driving the net and scoring the tough, dirty goals, but he's playing solid defensively. He's getting the puck out. He's winning his battles in the defensive zone. And because of that, because of Pettersson, you don't hear about him a lot. But if you're a Vancouver Canucks fan, you know how good he is. You know how important he is to the team. And I think all the fan base of Vancouver knows that he is the leader on and off the ice of this club.
Yeah, I agree. And you hear a lot about Brock Besser as well, right? He had a terrific first year. So that's part of it. But Bo Horvat, watching him play.
He's a fun one.
He's a grinder. And he's got some skill.
Be around for a long time, the way he plays.
All right.
I like that you make predictions every time you're on our show. Yeah, future captain.
I'm not afraid to be wrong.
No,
you're not. That's a quality that I really admire in you, actually. Jeff Skinner, for you.
Yeah, you know, Jeff Skinner came over in the trade with the Carolina Hurricanes.
Now, how'd that work out?
It's working out really nicely so far for the Buffalo Sabres. He's been on fire and the 13 goals, 7 assists, 20 points, plus 12 this year in the 18 games. He's playing over 17 and a half minutes per game. He's just been a great fit in Buffalo so far. I remember talking to Johnny McClain, our old buddy, who had him as an assistant coach in Carolina, and he said, boy, Jeff Skinner's a really talented guy. And, you know, again, like I talked about with Tyson Barrie, if you want to examine every element of his game, you can nitpick and find some things that he doesn't do maybe as well defensively. But look at the numbers here. This is a very talented guy. He's had some injury issues in his career. He's getting to play with some really a high-end player in Jack Eichel and some really high-end guys there in Buffalo. And he is making it happen so far. So I'm glad that Jeff has been healthy. I'm glad he's got kind of a fresh start in Buffalo. And who knows what's going to happen because contract is up. Free agent. Buffalo Sabres, I will tell you this.
They want him back.
They're not afraid to spend money.
No.
So it'll be interesting to see how that plays out. But he's been a great fit for the Sabres so far. So we need to maybe pump those tires up a little bit for Jeff Skinner.
Credit check. Yeah. Also, the way he skates is very interesting. You see him open up a lot. Sidney Crosby does it. But he almost skates up and down the ice that way. 10-2. So amazing.
Figure skating background. Oh, yeah. He was a figure skater as a young boy. And
that's how you get good on your edges.
Yes.
You get good on your edges.
And the perfect time for him to be performing at the level that he is.
Yes, it is.
It's all about timing in life.
Right?
Yes, it is.
It really is.
To get paid, if you play well that important year, you're going to get paid.
It goes a long way, as they say. Yes. And we go from one player in a new place to another guy in Michael Furland, who's also in a new place and performing very well.
Oh, I love Michael Furland's game. He came over to Carolina with Dougie Hamilton in the trade for Noah Hanifin and Lindholm. And for the reasons that I mentioned Timo Meier is hard to play against, Michael Furland's very similar. Probably even tougher in a way. I think Michael Furland's not afraid to drop the gloves. He will fight. But around the net, you'll see him score most of his goals. But the power play is when he's made a big difference this year. And that's standing in the slot, whether it be up high and looking for that bump pass right there or getting down and screening the goalie. But, I mean, these are big stats. And especially a team like Carolina who came over, they changed a lot this summer. They have a new coach. They made a couple, they made the one big trade. And he's a guy who came over and they didn't know. I think they figured what they get, but he's exceeded expectations. And that's because he has more skill than people realize. So Sebastian Aho is the number one player there. But Furland's come a long way in terms of playing with him. And like I said, being on the power play, making a difference
he's
there.
He's sandy. He's got
very
that sandpaper. He makes it hard to play. He's a big guy, too.
Big guy. And he fit in perfectly in Calgary. That's kind of like how they like to play. Yeah. But he's also done the same thing in Carolina.
Yeah, missing ingredient in Carolina.
Yep.
And a UFA after this season.
I like the guys' UFAs. I want these guys to get paid.
That's get paid,
credit,
baby.
Credit check. You won't be checking their credit after they sign for $30 million this
summer.
Good.
Good credit.
Very good credit. Yes. One more each.
All right, I'm going to go with David Rittich, the backup goaltender for the Calgary Flames. And guess what? He may not be the backup goalie much longer with numbers like these.
I know.
He has been terrific so far. He's played in 8 games, 5-1 record. You can see that save percentage, .935. Mike Smith has really struggled. And I love Mike Smith, and I'm sure in Calgary they brought him in to be the guy. But at some point in time, if he doesn't get his game going, I think you got to give Rittich more time. And I think if he continues to play that he's played, and you see the numbers there,
a big difference.
It's been really tough for Mike so far, and we love Mike Smith, and I got faith he'll get it together. But I think if he's an older goaltender. And I think Bill Peters is smart here. He'll give Rittich a little bit more of an opportunity. Like, Yarhalak has gotten more opportunity because he's played well, even though they have Tuukka Rask there. I think this league, it's a winning business, as all these coaches will tell you. And you've got to find ways to get those Ws night after night after night. Rittich has played well. I would give him more of an opportunity.
And also, Monahan's had a great start at a point per game. Goudreau's been good, but this is the MVP right now. He's only played 8 games. Without him, where are they at? Mike Smith has struggled. So
it's a big difference.
He's been good enough to really kind of keep them over .500 and playing some
good
hockey.
Give him a little more time.
Exactly.
A little more time. Mike Smith will get the start tomorrow. Calgary at home playing host to the Montreal Canadiens.